Well, those lyrics were very much the product of my frustrated 22-year-old self. And I think there's a part of me, I've certainly made peace with a lot of those feelings. So it always feels weird to dredge up an old conflict and put it out on a new record, because it can feel like a step backwards, because here it's like you're giving this statement to the world, like, I'm so conflicted about this thing, where actually I'm really not. And I thought that some of the lyrics were like a little too angsty and a little too amateur. And I don't know, I think I let Ben win, because that's why I chose him as a producer, was to override my decisions. And he was right, and the production job he did on it was almost like a challenge. Then he had to make it really, really good, and he did. I mean, I think what he did to the song is just genius. So he was right. Yeah, it was written right at the same time, actually, like within the same 6 months. That's true, but that was done on purpose. I mean, that whole song was kind of supposed to be an homage to the whole idea of the Velvet Underground doing that, and so I tried to put in as many as possible to make it really, really apparent. There were some David Bowie quotes in there too originally, they were in the verse that got cut. So. But yeah, Blake also loved the Velvet Underground and David Bowie, so it all made sense. Yeah, I mean, the original idea, there were two main ideas with the making of the series. One was that we wanted to make the videos as simple as possible, and we wanted to make captured performances. So no huge concepts, no big plots, no hitting the lamp, I feel like Michael Pope and I got a little lost in the Dresden Dolls with like writing these plots and concepts and taking on too much. When in fact, some of the strongest music videos are just a great caught performance, a direct performance, and we kept referring back to the Sinead O'Connor video. It's like, it was just her head, but it's a powerful fucking video. And that's what we did with Astronaut and Runs in the Family and Strength. I mean, it was really, the idea was, let's not overcomplicate anything. It's gonna be you and the camera, and you're going to lip sync the songs and slay it. And take advantage of the fact that you're a strong performer. And we also wanted to tie it in with the idea of Who Killed Amanda Palmer as kind of a concept and an idea. So we threaded together the videos with these sort of in-between vignettes, and that's actually gonna actually become a little clearer later when things sort of wrap up. Probably Strength Through Music, because I don't think I've ever made a video that's as emotionally powerful as that. And I felt like we had to be so careful with a song like that, that the video could, it was just not allowed to be tacky. The song was too important for that, and it had to be something so simple and effective and not sentimental. And I think we did it. I think we managed to get it. And for that, I'm really, really glad. And the process of that video was also, it was amazing, because we were working with real high school kids. And you couldn't help but know that they were going through this process and this afternoon in their high school, running from the hall, running through the halls from this imaginary classmate who's chasing after them with a gun, knowing how real it is, and knowing that not very far away this has just happened. And they were really affected by it. And just watching that process happen was heavy in itself. Really different. The Leeds United video is like a big budget, very tongue-in-cheek, kind of making fun of a diva rock star. And we shot it in London with a lot of the fans, and it's very silly, and it was lots of fun to shoot, and there's a big food fight, and there's lots of, you know, lots of people in the video. And the Oasis one was another sort of smaller budget, pretty much fixed camera, very probably offensive to a lot of people, we'll find out. Literal theatrical presentation of the song. I'm very excited about that one. I think it's incredibly hilarious. We'll see. I think the Christian right might not be so excited about it, but we'll see how that goes. Hopefully Obama gets elected president, we won't have to worry about it. There's some choreography that we had to cut, and there's some moments where I'm supposed to jump onto that side of the stage or run over there where I have to just be picked up by one of the actors and plunked down, and then picked up by another actor and put over here. But it actually, it's funny in the show, so it works. We worked around it. I haven't had to cancel a single thing. Not even the day of the accident. I went straight to the show.